All right, everyone, so Canvas is not working at the moment, so we're gonna do this the low-tech way. I printed out the important part of it, and I'm gonna pass these out, and then also the documents of importance I will give to you, I will give you those digitally in a moment. So hopefully Canvas will work sometime later today, but here is the assignment. Let's take a quick look at this, the Webmaster Tools assignment. So I'm going to give you three documents. We'll look at these together in a moment. But the assignment says the setup is that you're going to download the company profile, the marketing strategy, and that you're going to create some blog posts. So I'll give you these documents in a moment. Blog checklist, company profile, marketing strategy. These are what's going to be used for the final assignment. But again, don't think of it like a final project where it's the culmination of everything. It's just one more assignment. It just happens to be the final assignment. So we're going to have this company profile that'll open in a moment. You're going to need to fill it out yourself and fill it out for your own business. The various things that it asks about your business, you fill that all in. There's going to be seven sections that I'll go through in just a moment. Seven sections related to your company that you'll need to fill out. There's a part there for your name as well. So the company profile is one thing you'll need to complete for the assignment by next week. Then there's also going to be the marketing strategy. So we dove head first into social media. And if we'd never used social media before, especially for business, well, I don't know what I'm doing. That's fine. It wasn't meant to be an assignment that you're a social media pro. You know, take our other classes or educate yourself more and you'll get closer to that. But one of the things about getting better at social media for business is to have a marketing strategy, a marketing plan. So this marketing strategy document will be related to that. Again, when I give that to you, I'll show you that you need to fill out a few sections, answer a few questions, make sure your name is on it, turn it in and such. We're also going to have a blog post part of the project. So that is going to be about creating content. We looked at Twitter as a form of creating short content. Blog posts are for longer content. And there's a document here, the blog checklist, which we'll look at. So you're going to need to do these things, and it got cut off at the end, but what do you think the due date is? The last day of class, which is Tuesday the 6th. Now, on that one, that's going to be due at the end of the class, 4 p.m. So this will be on Canvas, of course, but if you want to write it down, this assignment is due August 6th at 4 p.m. Our class ends at 4 p.m., and the last day of class is next week in August, the first week of August. So that's what's going to be due next time. The details then, okay, what is it that you need to do? It's right here. If you go over to the web design folder, I've downloaded the files that you need. These will be on Canvas, of course. But if you go to the web design folder on the desktop, and then you go to our class, CIS256, there's a brand new folder there for you, CIS256 week 8. Copy that folder to your desktop or flash drive. Don't just open it up, you want to copy it, so make sure you copy it. If you make a change to my file, you're making a change to everyone's file, so be sure don't do that. Copy this, drag it, copy it to your desktop. Once you've got a copy on your desktop, close my network folder and then open your copy. So make sure you copy that to your computer. Better yet, to your flash drive. Copy it to your flash drive so you can take it with you. And again, this is right off of Canvas, but it doesn't seem to be working. Actually, Canvas is working in my office, but we all cannot fit in there. So when you get home, it might finally work. But these documents right there are on Canvas. Let's look at those documents, the CIS 256 week 8. let's start with the first one that I've got in the homework here, which is the company profile. So we've got three documents: blogging checklist, company profile, marketing strategy. These are editable Word documents, so any word processor should be able to open them, Google Docs as well. So let's open client company profile. Now, I mentioned before, I teach this stuff for Southwestern College. I also teach for San Diego City College. I teach a bunch of classes related to programming or technology, social media, web design, etc. But before all of that, I got a degree in graphic design and web and business and all of that. And so I do this stuff also for clients. If a client were to hire me as a webmaster, as a web designer, social media manager, whatever the title, if a company were to hire me or my company, we would need to do a good job for that company. I'm going to get hired for XYZ company that they want to increase their sales. Well, the owners of the business, they know their company inside and out. They know, the foundational aspects of it. How did it come to be? So they know what their product is. They know what's great about it. They know why you should buy it. Well, if they're hiring me or my company, I don't know that yet. I know that you've hired me and I want to do a good job. I want to make money. I don't want to get fired. I want to do a good job for your business. Well, this document is one of the documents that would help me as a web designer to figure out what do I need to know about your company in order to do a good job for your company to make money. Well, if I'm getting hired, I need to know, okay, what's the company name? Victor's Bakery. But the more detailed that I write about it, well, why is it Victor's Bakery? Is it the name of the actual owner? Is it the name of their grandfather? Is it just a funny name? Like, what's the name? Why is the name of the business that? What's a tagline? Does it have a slogan? No, we don't have a slogan. Do I need a slogan? Probably. Because if I've got a name of a company like, you know, Victor's Bakery, it's obvious that there seems to be some sort of bakery. But if I have a name like, you know, Victor Designs, does that tell you web design, interior design, graphic design? What kind of design? A slogan or a tagline is one sentence that explains what the business is. And some slogans are so famous, you know exactly what business it is. What's the business that uses the tagline, "I'm loving it"? McDonald's. What's the business that uses the tagline or slogan, "Just do it"? Nike. Well, when Nike debuted 40 years ago or whatever, if they had a slogan, "Just do it," what does that even mean? Just do what? Do your taxes? Like, what is that about? So nowadays, that slogan is synonymous with the company. For us, okay, Victor's Bakery, I could do something, you know, San Diego Bakery. That's it. Or if I have some sort of name like, you know, Victor Designs, great interior design for a great life. You know, some sort of tagline that explains what the business is in one sentence. So your assignment, let me show the other aspect of this. I'm talking about this in terms of if I get hired, I need to be able to promote your business well. Therefore, I need to know about your business. For the class, for yourself, you are your own business. You are going to fill this out for yourself so that you know the basic aspects of your business, so that then you can use these things for more advanced things, such as the social media. What am I going to tweet about? What am I going to put on Instagram? What kind of photos am I going to do? Well, I threw you to that assignment just to kind of see, you know, what you would get out of it. But that assignment in the social media class would be much more detailed. We would do something like this plus more prep to get into the social media. I just threw you to use social media. But this assignment helps you lay that foundation, because when you figure out what are the values of my company, you know, orderliness, cleanliness, friendliness, whatever way that I describe the company, well, that's going to help me. I'm going to tweet about friendliness or orderliness or compassion. I'm going to create content that represents the personality of my company. So like personality, am I going to have like fun animated graphics and funny memes and all of that for like perhaps a daycare center? Probably. I want to take care of kids. I want to have fun. Show a welcoming environment. Yeah, I'll put some fun SpongeBob memes on my Twitter. However, what about if I am a tax preparer? Are you going to have very much confidence in someone that's putting all of these jokey memes and all that stuff when I'm trusting them with my tax returns and all that serious stuff? So the personality of your business, if you define what it is, it helps you create the content about your business. And this particular assignment is a variation of what my company has done for clients. I've had several clients throughout the years, and what I teach in these classes are real things that I would do for real clients. So we would do this, we would sit down with the owner, we would ask him these things. We would figure all of this stuff out so that we get a better sense of what your business is, so that my business can do a good job. For yourself, it's also very valuable, isn't it? Once I know this, once I've written one paragraph or so of about the company, I can use this on the various biography sites or biographies of my sites. I can put the same little paragraph on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram to keep it consistent. And once I get more experience in other concepts, I can use those keywords throughout my various sites. So this is one of the things you need to do as the last assignment. You fill this all out with your name and the company name and the date. There's also a spot to fill out. Actually, did I miss this? Add your last name to the footer. Okay, yeah. So down on the footer, yeah, right there, you need to put your last name there as well. That's easy. But then you need to figure these things out. And you don't have to write a whole essay. You can keep it to, one screen long if you want, or if you want to write more. Again, this is not just like an assignment. It is hopefully that you learn these things to actually do it with a real business. And most of you are here with a real business that you care about. So you've got something to work with that. Does this make sense? Any more like clarification on any of the points of this particular document? Maybe as you work with it, you'll come up with more questions and email me and such. But does it make sense? Any questions on this document? Okay, this is one of the three things you need to do. Moving on to the second one in the folder, we've got the marketing strategy. So the company profile was like very matter of fact. This is literally our tagline and the mission. What we're trying to do is we're gonna sell stuff. This is our mission. But the marketing strategy is a little bit more theoretical. If you go to that document, once again, you have to fill it in, page one, and you got various points, 5 points here. Now it's a little bit kind of deeper. And if you notice, these are kind of more open-ended questions. What do you want to accomplish? So why do you have a website? Why do you have an Etsy store? Why do you have an Instagram? What are you trying to do online? I've got my business that's been on Main Street for 10 years, and we just decided to get on Facebook or Twitter or blogging or whatever. Well, what is going to be the purpose of that online aspect of your business? Sometimes businesses just get online because they think they have to, or they need to, or that's the thing you have to do. If you're not going to use your online presence, then it's not that useful to you. So take a moment to write about what you want to accomplish. The example here, Vic.co wishes to create a powerful social media presence because we want to interact with existing customers and through word of mouth reach new customers. We want to connect with people on Instagram in a visual way. So I have a general idea that I want to use Instagram with a lot of photos. And I want to use social media, maybe Twitter or Facebook, to interact or try to find brand new customers. So there's a couple of goals about what my online presence, what I'm trying to do with it. If you just write, for example, sell products, that's okay. That's a nice C plus answer. That's too nice. That's a nice C minus answer. You want to get more detailed, not just write like, how long should this be? I'm not really saying how long should it be. What does it make sense? Does it explain to me what your business is? Because obviously you know your business, but if you're trying to explain it to me, did you tell me enough to explain the business? have you thought of a target audience? I've dealt with so many clients that they say, everyone is my potential customer. I remember a few years ago, someone was contacted my company to sell their product. And of course, we asked them, who's your target audience? Who are you trying to sell to? They said, everyone. Well, their product was baby strollers. Raise your hand if you need a baby stroller. See that. So, not everyone is your target audience. Even for them, their target audience, they figured out eventually, we want to target first-time parents, first-time Latino parents. That's our target audience. Now you can focus. Now you can create social media or a website that focuses on that audience. If I just said anyone that needs a stroller, maybe that'll work. But if you focus it more, maybe this week I'll be tweeting to this particular audience that needs a stroller. Maybe next week I'll be posting Instagram photos that target this audience that needs a stroller. So writing it down here in the form of a persona, a fictional person, this could be literally something like, okay, John, 20-year-old, college student, minimum wage, parties every weekend. You know, this is, real companies do this. Coca-Cola, Chipotle, all of these companies create these audiences, these fictional people. But they're not, they could be real people. People that are in that age range, in that location, people that would be interested in their product. So for this particular one, can you define one or two fictional people that would be interested in your product? Because when you create your tweets or your blog posts, you're thinking, would this person be interested in my product? My product right now that I'm selling costs $500. Well, this person's earning minimum wage. They're going to have to save up a lot of money to get to that product. But I sell this other product that is more affordable. So how can I tweet about this product that is a little bit more affordable because I need to reach John? And then what about if I develop the persona for Janet and she's a millionaire? Well, what? How would I tweet to reach that audience? Do you have other companies that you see what they're doing and you want to do something like them or better or get ideas from or inspiration? So you can list some companies. Who else is perhaps a competitor? And they don't have to be a competitor literally in the same city. They could be somewhere global, another state or country. They don't have to be exactly the same industry, although it makes more sense. Like if I'm a bakery, I want to see what other sort of small local bakeries are there. You know, what are some local bakeries? 98 Degrees, what are they doing? 89 Degrees, what's the name of that one bakery with a Degrees in their title? Anyone know that one in National City? What's it called? 89 Degrees, 98, something like that? 85 Degrees? Yeah, 85 Degrees. What other bakeries are there? Arelli's Bakery up there in Claremont Mesa or something. So I need to figure out who might be a competitor. Let me go check their website. Let me check their Facebook. What are they doing and can I get inspired? Can I aspire to do what they're doing? So one of the ways to do marketing and social media is to see what's the competition doing. The fancy term is competitor analysis. You can easily look up on any of these social networks, you know, what is Chipotle doing? I have a Mexican food restaurant too. Oh, look at that, that's interesting. I wanted to look up Chipotle, the company, but it came up to this guy. Chip Cloth, all right. Interesting. I thought the company Chipotle would have the Twitter address Chipotle, but they probably have some other. If I spell it right, there it is. Chipotle tweets. So they had to settle for Chipotle tweets because somebody already claimed it, and they haven't used it since 2015. No, actually, wait a minute. There it is. 22 hours ago. Never mind. Yeah. So this guy's active. But the point of this is, I can go look up any website, any competitor. Here they're typing Morse code. That's funny. And check out what their discounts are or any sorts of ideas and see what Just get ideas from what other people are doing. Yes, we deliver to Area 51. Hello, fellow children. So, the thing is, I can use this as who else can I check out as a possible competition, and obviously not steal their ideas, but what about a version of it? Or what are trends that are going on, and can I do my own version of things? The previous document had a mission statement. This one has a vision statement. A mission statement says like what you're doing right now, what's your goal right now for your business, and a vision is what is your goal in some amount of time. You know, I want to be San Diego's number one daycare center in the next 5 years. So when you have some sort of goal written down, hopefully you can get to the goal as this, you know, this goalpost to get to if you've got it written down. And then we have the USP, the unique selling proposition. What is unique about you to sell your product? What makes you different from the other companies? There's plenty of other real estate companies or daycare centers or bakeries or whatever, but what is unique about me? My location, my ingredients, my attitude, my personnel. So, for example, Uber was one of the big first ride-sharing companies, and then Lyft came out. Well, why would I want Lyft if Uber's already a thing? Well, Lyft tried to differentiate themselves with that pink mustache on their cars. Remember that? And then it used to be that like the Lyft people would high-five you all the time or something. So they were trying to be more personable and fun compared to Uber. And so can I do something that is different from my competition? What is unique about mine? And so you might not be able to fully answer all of these things 100%. You have the week to work on it. You have also the ability to email me and ask me questions and such. And especially if you're a beginner to this stuff, it's not going to be perfect. That's fine. I would recommend you take a version of this and also save a copy of it without any changes. Keep a copy of this. You can easily make a copy. Keep a copy right there for you to reuse as you learn more about this stuff, as you change your strategy. There's that copy that I can come back to again and again if I want to you know, start fresh. This is the second of the three things you need to do for the next assignment. Any questions on this one, the marketing strategy? Okay, the third one, if we look at the third document, this one's more literally a checklist. So if you go to that one, blogging checklist. Social media is a very short attention span type of media. Medium in terms of a tweet used to be 140 characters. What can you say in a short time? Then they doubled it to 280. Facebook has a limit also of how much you can write, but I think it's something like 1,000 characters. So most of these networks have, most of these social networks have a shortest attention span. Instagram, you put a photo, maybe some text below it, and you're done. What's next? Look, what else can I like? What else can I see? Blogging is the opposite. Blogging is where you're going to read 500 words, where you're going to read 1,000 words, where you can go into detail and nuance. Social media could be more of the hot take, and blogging could be more of a nuanced thing. So the second part of the assignment is create two blog posts. You have a website. If you've got a WordPress website, there's an easy way to create posts. You go to the section Posts, Create New. You need to create two blog posts, at least 100 words long, at least one image, an internal external link. What does that mean? Well, it comes from here. So if you find the section about images, let's see, planning, writing, images. Choose images that relate to the topic. Use your own original images or stock images, also known as royalty-free or public domain images. I mentioned Pixabay as a place to get images. File names need to be meaningful. That means that a lot of times if you take your own photo, when you download the photo to your computer, most likely it'll be something like image dash the date, and then the time dot JPEG. That, even a little thing like that, is not too useful for you for SEO or search engine accessibility, because that's pretty meaningless. Even the names of your files have a purpose for your website to be visible. So a better name would be something like cookie platter large.jpg. The actual kind of explanation of what that photo is. You don't know what the photo is at all just by the name of it right out of your camera. So that's a little thing to do that is valuable. Personally, what I like to do, this one is like bad. If you just leave your images like that, this one is good. But then what I like to do is I like to combine both. And yes, it's a very long name. That's okay, because it's got the keywords, it's got real words that explain what the image is, plus the original file name. Because what I do when I take my photos off my phone or my regular Canon camera, I make a backup of them somewhere safe, and then I edit the copy. Well, if the copy is called Cookie Platter, I'm never going to be able to find the original photo out of my camera, because out of my camera, the photo is called image 297 whatever. So what I like to do is combine both, so that when I go back to my archives, I can go search for this, and I know that this will be in the folder. And so that one's bad, that one's good, and obviously this one's gooder. So the naming scheme is something important as well, and that's something that I note in this document. So this document checklist is just things to do, like alt text. Things to do when you create blogs, even though I don't have, like, make sure you have headings. I have these bullet points for you to look at, of things to set up and to do for an effective blog post, because this, again, is content. A website, it's like, you know, just eating the icing on the cake. I want the cake too. I want the whole complete picture, so the content of your website, not just how nice does it look, cool effects that it has, it's the content. You have blog posts, you have pictures, you have content, coupons, products, content. So the third thing you need to do is create content. Write two articles about your products with the items that I have here, at least 100 words, an image to show it off, etc. So those three things are the things that are going to be graded on, and I cut off the part how many points it is, but it's either 10 or 20, but probably 10 points, and that'll be due on the last day of class. So you'll have the week to work on it, little lab time right now if you need it. When you come back on the last day, it'll be an individualized thing that I'll grade you on. There'll be one extra credit opportunity on the last day if you want to show off any of this stuff for the class. You can come up here, pull up your document, talk about any of these documents, you'll get some extra credit. That's optional, last day of class. So that's the third part, writing some blog posts. Question?
Where do we write the blog posts?
Depending on your website. So if I've got, this is my website here, pmdinteractive.com. This is a WordPress site, like all of our sites here. You're gonna have, I called my news, but you'll have a section in your WordPress site that says posts. In that section of posts, they'll be new, so you add a new post.
So I only have a WordPress site for my last semester. Do I just put it on there?
You can use that. Yeah, you can use that one, or you could set yourself up with MAMP. You know that site that you made from MAMP. You can add it there.
It doesn't have to be live?
It doesn't have to be live, no. So if you don't have a real live site, you can put it on MAMP. If you do have a real site, use that one. Okay.
So then how do we turn it in if it's on MAMP?
Well, on that last day of class, I'll go to you individually and at your station, and then you can show me at your station. So on the last day of class, you'll turn in those two Word documents, and then I will see on your map or real site your particular blog posts. Yes.
So this is due August 6th?
Yeah, the last day of class.
That's our last day of class, okay.
Yeah, the last day of class, August 6th. So the two Word documents plus the two blog posts all due on the last day of class, the 6th, by 4 p.m.
So how do you do an internal link if it's on MAMP?
An internal link is just like, okay, on this particular blog post, this is an article about the marketing strategy. There's a link right here to the actual document. There's a link here to a previous article in this series. So an internal link is just a link back to some other post or screen of your own website. And then an external link is a link to someone else's website.
How would you do an internal link on WordPress?
I'll try to log in a moment, but when you select your text to make it be an active link and you get the pop-up to add a link, WordPress gives you a spot there to type an address. If you start typing the name of your own article or post, it'll automatically know you mean it to be your own article on your own website, and that will then create an active internal link. If you need to see exactly how it is, I can show you on your screen there. But when you do it in WordPress and it pops up, it's there.
So you select the text and then what, you right-click?
There'll be a button at the top here that says add a link. And when you turn on the button that says add a link, then it pops up to say type the address of an external link or type the name of one of your other pages, and then it'll link it. All right, so that's the idea for the moment. You'll have some lab time to get started if you want. And when we come back next time, it'll be the last time, the last day of class on the 6th.